This morning, my alarm went off at 5 a.m. Now, that's the third time it's gone off at that time this week. I'm not normally a morning person, but since signing up for swim practice, I am getting up earlier than normal. But yesterday when it went off, I subconsciously pressed snooze on my alarm and so missed practice. So this morning when it went off, I made sure I got up as tired as I was because I needed to make up that session. So I splashed some water on my face, I brushed my teeth, I threw all of my gear into my backpack, including my fins, my cap, my goggles, my snorkel, all the stuff that I put on last night when FaceTiming my niece and nephew to show them what I had to wear to swimming, and they did nothing but howl at me. But that's okay. I shoved it all in my bag. I even had time to make a quick coffee, and out the door I went, spilling the coffee all over me as I locked the door behind me. Anyhow, I raced to the pool and got there with almost a whole minute to spare, only to find out that swim practice on Thursday mornings is actually a half an hour later than my normal Monday and Wednesdays. My initial thought, you could have slept for an entire 30 more minutes. But then I thought, 30 extra minutes. What can I do with this time to be more productive? So I found a coffee shop less than a block away. I got out my journal and I started making lists. I love lists. The first was more of a brain dump. I got out everything that I had going on in my life right now. The second list, all of my business offerings and things that I wanted to focus on as we begin to close out 2018 and look forward to 2019. And the third list, identifying my top priorities and things I had to get done today. Put the book away, ran into the change room, almost late again, and then had a really great swim practice. I made some new friends, including the receptionist on Thursday morning called Nefertiti, whose name actually means Queen of the Nile. Had a really great conversation with her, a great conversation with a gentleman who I found out recently climbed Kilimanjaro. So he shared some insights and learnings for me as we get prepped and ready to go in January. And then I thought, you know what? It's not even 8 o'clock and I've had some really great moments and I haven't even attacked my to-do list. So it made me think about our whole idea behind what it does mean to be productive. So I looked it up. And productive actually means producing or able to produce large amounts of goods, crops, or other commodities. And I thought, well, first of all, are you able even to use a word or a variation of that word in the definition of itself? I'm not sure, but I'm choosing a different definition. Enjoying or able to enjoy large amounts of meaning, connection, and other such, not commodities, but moments. So how can we be more productive in our day by allowing ourselves to just be in the moment? Here are three things that you can do to maybe change your view of what it means to be productive. The first, define. Define your definition of productivity. Number two, dump. Dump the to-do list. Or maybe not dump it entirely, but maybe change your way of looking at it and don't necessarily judge how good or not so good you can feel about your day based on how much of your to-do list you've actually gotten through. I'm guilty of it too. However, doesn't necessarily mean that we deserve to feel proud or more accomplished based on the items we can check off. And then third, dedicate. Dedicate a few minutes at the end of your day not to congratulate how many things you've accomplished, but instead to celebrate how many moments you remember. Let's change our whole opinion on what it means to be productive so that we can allow ourselves to enjoy more meaning, more connection, and more moments that matter. I want to hear from you as you share your ideas and thoughts below. And until next time, I'm Carol Schulte, experiential keynote speaker, founder of Living Big, and committed to bringing the biggest you to all you do. We'll see you next time.